Hey gang, wanted to give you a little overview of things dealing with color temperature in your light project. Now, one thing to consider is that most of the lamps that you're going to have access to are going to be household, either incandescent or LEDs like we talked with. But one of the things you might not be aware of is that those do come in a specific range of what we call color temperature. And I'm going to edit this so you can see. But there is a chart called a Kelvin scale that determines the light temperature. Most, if you've been through a physics class, you know that light can come in a couple different flavors, but when we're dealing with the math of lighting, we're thinking of it in terms of its wavelength size. So a white light will produce multiple shades of color or multiple wavelengths of light. However, not all white light is the same. So you have different color temperatures. Now, most incandescent lamps, think of our stage lights. This light I have back here illuminating me is what we would consider warm temperature light, which puts it into the 2500 to 3500 range on the Kelvin scale. If you go a little bit further up the Kelvin scale, it goes from more orange colored light to blue light. And you may have seen fluorescent lights in a department store like Walmart, where the light looks white, but it looks a little bit more tinted towards blue. Those would be what we call a cooler Kelvin temperature, and it has a higher rating. The other thing that you might have noticed is that if you buy a light bulb, that light bulb on the back will have kind of like, it looks like the nutrition information on the back of food, which is kind of funny. But it'll have a couple things, information about the brightness of the light, which is usually directly related to the wattage. Higher wattage lamps consume more energy, but as a trade-off, they're brighter. But down sort of in the bottom of it, you'll see something that says light appearance, and it'll have a little scale. It'll say warm or cool. The lower number lamps are warmer. Typically 2700 is kind of where LEDs are trying to go to get closer to that warm color temperature. Cooler lights, some people like the bluer light, so you can buy cool lights that have that as well. But it comes back to this Kelvin scale, which gives you the option of either warm, oranger light, or bluer light. But it's still, it's emitting in the wavelengths of, all of visible light, which goes from like 400 nanometers up to 750 nanometers is what our eyes can perceive. So think of, your visible and invisible light, it's all x-rays is below us, radio waves is above us. As the electromagnetic spectrum, you go through it, there's all kinds of different wavelengths that we can deal with, but light is the only part that we can see, and that's that small portion right there. And you can see down here at the 400 end, you get into the ultraviolet, which is a little bit more purple or indigo, and then you go to blues, greens, oranges, and then on up to red is all the visible light that we can see. So let me find the chart I was going to look at. Oh, okay. So if you've been outside at night, and these are starting to disappear too, but the street lights are kind of orange colored. Those are actually sodium lights. They use sodium and they energize it inside of a lamp, and the sodium tends to glow more orange. So they're very warm colored lights. But this is a chart of a typical high pressure sodium bulb, the 250 watt, whatever, and it shows you that it has a peak wavelength around the green up into the red, and it kind of tapers off as it gets into extreme red, but there's also some blue there. And those colors, those wavelengths of light mix together to make that warm orange glow. But you can see that there's multiple little peaks and stuff on the visible light spectrum, and all of those wavelengths combine to give you that Kelvin rating, which would be on the way extreme orange side of things. So all of this is to say is that as you're doing your project here, some things to consider. The more orange the light is, the warmer the light is, the more on this part of the spectrum, the higher wavelength, higher nanometer light is going to come out of it. So if you put a blue filter in front of it, now keep in mind this is blue because it's filtering out everything except what we see on this part of the spectrum. So if we go over to the technical data sheet, because all gel filters have this little sheet And there's a lot of numbers here and a lot of science that really doesn't matter for what we're doing. But just think of it this way. This is R80, which is Roscoe 80, the gel. And you can see if I hold it up, it's very blue. But if you look at the colorimetric chart, it allows the higher part of the graph here. It shows that it allows more blue light through, and then almost no yellow green on this part of it, and then it peaks up again. It adds actually a little bit of the red wavelength, so it adds some red wavelength. But then if you look at this and you go back to the sodium peaks around 600 nanometers. So if we were to put a gel of blue in front of this, most of the visible light coming out of the sodium light is actually going to be blocked by this blue filter. So the consequence of that is it's going to get dimmer. So if you have an incandescent bulb that has, let's say, 27K, most of the visible light that's coming out of it is going to be in that orange reddish section, which is going to be blocked by this filter. So when you put a blue gel in front of a warm fixture, the upshot of that is that it will filter most of the light. And what's the consequence when you filter light? The byproduct is heat. So that's why if you put a blue filter in front of an incandescent lamp, your blue gels are going to wear out faster than your pinks or your ambers, because the pink and the amber is letting most of the visible light out of that fixture to go through it without absorbing it. But with your blue gels, this is absorbing a bulk of the light that comes out of it. So let's look at another gel I've got here. I've got R46, and I'll pull up the chart on that puppy. And you can see it's very different. There's not very much blue. There's a little spike down here in the 400 nanometer range. But then most of the light that's coming through this filter is in the orange, and then it peaks up in towards the red. So your 27K, which is going to have more of this, is going to have a lot more light that would be allowed to pass through it. These gels, in my experience, 46, I've rarely had to replace them because they very rarely burn through. So if you're doing your lighting project and you have, let's say, just a regular house bulb, and you put a gel in front of it, the red is going to allow more light to transmit. So some of you that have done it already have said, oh, I've got a window in my room, there's a lot of natural light coming in, I'm competing with that. So try maybe a red filter to see if you can get that. The other options you have with competing with natural light is to move away from the window, try and find a different room that maybe doesn't have as many windows, or if you have blinds or something like that. That can help too. But I wanted to give you some ideas, because your light source is going to dictate how bright you can be. So let's say you do have a blue filter of some type that you found and you want to increase the output. Well, if you have it available, try and find in your house a light bulb that has a higher color temperature or a more blue color temperature. The old compact fluorescents that you still see around, they're being quickly replaced by the LED lights. But the CFLs are the little screw shape on the top of them. When they first came out, a lot of them were the higher color temperature because the phosphor inside of them, for whatever reason, it seemed like they like to use the cooler color temperatures with those. So those I see a lot more frequently with that really blue color temperature. Sometimes it almost looks green in a sense, but it all comes back to that Kelvin scale, which the Kelvin scale, keep in mind, is different from the nanometer scale, because at any point along here, the visible light output from any given white light source is going to be a combination of wavelengths. There's going to be another chart that you could look up that will show what kind of visible light's outputting. But keep in mind, if you have a lamp that's outputting a lot of warm light, it's not going to, output much in the wavelength that would be filtered out, by this blue filter. So just some things to keep in mind as you're going through your projects. Maybe experiment if you have the ability and have light bulbs lying around your house. Try different ones to see what kind of effect you can have modifying those to with the different color media that you can find. But I have to say, I love what I've seen so far. Fed Abby and Jesse and Hannah have all turned in some stuff, and it looks really cool. It seems like you guys are digging into it. Jenna also did one so far. The last thing I want to say about that is I've had at least one person reach out to me and say that the other classes you're doing are kind of dumping a lot of work on you. And I get it, like, this is weird with this homeschool, online school, whatever. So if you do need more time with something, please let me know. Please let Ms. Seligman know. We're happy to give you guys that grace and allow the space for you to do the work that you need to do. You know me, I'm never a stickler for deadlines unless it's something that matters. You know, like, we have to build a set for a show that obviously has a deadline, but stuff like this, like, I'm happy to accept it when you're able to do it if it means that it will be a better product and you'll be able to put more time into it. So if you do need that time, reach out to me, reach out to Z, let us know. We're always happy to go back and change grades, so don't let this be a source of your anxiety or your stress. And on that note as well, if you do need help along those lines, feel free to reach out. I'm happy to help direct you to, you know, Miss Megan is the social worker, and I know a couple of you guys have met her before. She has that website. There's a lot of resources. The school is very aware that this is a difficult time for many of you, and we're here for you. We want you to know that, even though we're not physically meeting and together, but we're here for you guys and willing to help. So hope everyone's well, and we'll see you when we see you. Take care, gang.